Some consider James Douglas the father of British Columbia. Others believe it to be John McLaughlin, the governor who had mentored him for 15 years. Jean-Baptiste McLaughlin was born in Quebec, part French, baptized Catholic, trained as a medical doctor, married to an Aboriginal woman. He governed the British territory of Columbia for 20 years. He built the original Vancouver as his capital and established dozens of settlements from Boise, now Boise, to Taku, now in Alaska. He drove rapid economic growth with diplomatic trade offices in San Francisco and Honolulu. McLaughlin governed through Honorable Hudson Bay Company, a hybrid government corporation. His fierce business practices led U.S. trappers and maritime traders to eventually abandon the area. He was a friend of Native people. His wife, Marguerite, was Aboriginal, and his son married the daughter of his ally, the great Chinook chief, Concomly. In 1845, he was forced from office by powers in the East and settled in Oregon City, which he had founded. A year later, a weak British politician agreed to McLaughlin's worst fears, a border on the 49th parallel, undoing much of his life work, leaving 90% of his people in the U.S. Many newly arrived Americans were hostile to McLaughlin. The founding documents of Oregon legally confiscated his properties. Other land was taken by fraud. The new democracy expelled the Black and Hawaiian people he had supported, waged wars on the Native allies he had lived in peace with, and annulled the mixed marriages he had encouraged. Although he had worked to keep the United States out of Colombia, the treaty left him with a dilemma. He would have to abandon the people and place he had governed unless he became a U.S. citizen. His humanity was bigger than his nationality. His foundational role was edited out of British Columbia history. But his admirers erected a statue of him on our Parliament buildings in Victoria, looking east toward his betrayers. McLaughlin died regretful, believing he had failed in his life work. But he gave us a precious gift, a border decision without war or enmity. His longtime deputy, James Douglas, led the remnants of Columbia north to recreate a society modeled on the one McLaughlin had built. An Oregon congressman blamed one person for the existence of British Columbia. Dr. McLaughlin has cheated our government out of the whole country. John McLaughlin did not fail. For some, he remains the true father of British Columbia, and Marguerite, our true mother.